So now, so this is the one more problem, the tensile stress. This is the examination problem which has been appeared 3 times. The tensile test was conducted on a MS bar. The following data was obtained from the test. So he says the diameter of the steel bar of 16 mm. So gauge length of the bar is 80 mm. So he loaded the proportionality limit is 72 kN. So extension at a load of 60 kN is 0.115. Loaded failure is 80 kN. Final gauge length of the bar is 104. Diameter of the rod failure is 12 mm. So we have to determine the Young's modulus, the proportionality limit, the percentage elongation, and the true breaking stress. Now, here, to first the condition what we need to find out is the Young's modulus. So the Young's modulus is, so what is the definition of the Young's modulus? It is the stress by strain within the proportionality limit or the elasticity. Now, he says, so the loaded proportionality limit is given, so which is 72 kN. But when you come to the extension, he has given the extension at a load of 60 kN. So that means the delta L is given to be 0.115, which is the change in length or the extension, which is at 60 kN. But the proportionality is given to be 72 kN. So we cannot take this loaded proportionality limit as the stress, which is the load. That is because the extension what he has given is only for the 60 kN. So obviously, when you want to find out the stress, so we need to consider the stress at 60 kN. Because the change extension given is only for the period of, for the load of 60 kN. So therefore, so the Young's modulus is given by E, stress by strain. Stress by strain, which is sigma by epsilon. So that will be equal to, so sigma is P by A. So now we need to find out the stress. The stress is given to be sigma, which is equal to load by the area of cross section. So the load which will be have to be considered is 60 kN, because it is the extension given is for 60 kN. So sigma is P, which is 60 into 10 to the power of 3, which is Newton, into the diameter of the specimen, which is given by pi by 4 into 16 square. So that will be equal to 298.4155 Newton per mm square. Next is the strain. Strain, which is epsilon, which is given by delta L by L. Delta L by the change in length by the gauge length or the original length of the member, which will be equal to delta L is 0.115 divided by the length of this gauge length is 80 mm. So that will give you 1.4375 into 10 to the power of minus 3. 10 to the power of minus 3. Now we will going to find out the Young's modulus, which is given by E. Young's modulus, which is given by E, which will be equal to stress by strain. So that will be equal to sigma by epsilon, which will be equal to 298.4155 divided by the 1.4375 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So that will be equal to 207.593.4 Newton per mm square. So this is the value of the Young's modulus E. So the next condition what he has given is proportionality limit. So the proportionality limit is says, so the second one is the proportionality limit. So we have proportionality limit. So that is given by loaded proportional limit by original cross sectional area of the wall. So that will be proportionality limit is given by proportionality limit is given by loaded proportionality limit, load at proportionality limit by original cross sectional area, original cross sectional area. See, the load at proportionality limit is given to be 72 kilonewton. So that will be 72 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by the original cross sectional area, pi by 4 into 16 square, because it is the round bar. So that will be equal to 358.1 newton per mm square. So this is the value. So the next one will be true breaking stress, which will be given by true breaking stress. The third one is the true breaking stress. True breaking stress. So that is given by true breaking stress. Is given by the loaded failure, that is the loaded failure, load at failure divided by actual cross sectional area, that is the neck area, actual cross sectional area. So that will be equal to the loaded failure is 80 kilonewton. So 80 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by pi by 4 into diameter of the loaded failure, which is given by 12 square. So this is pi d square by 4, which will be 707.3553 newton per mm square. So the last one is given to be the percentage elongation. So the next one is the percentage elongation. The fourth one is the percentage elongation which is given by increase in length by the original length, that is the total increase in length by the original length. Total increase in length, increase in length by original length into 100, because it is in percentage, so into 100. So that is equal to, you can also write this as final length minus the original length, final length minus the original length, that is the gauge length, divided by the original length, into 100, which is in percentage, which will be into 100. So what is the final length of the specimen? That is the final gauge length of the bar is, after the failure, you will going to get it as 104 mm minus the original length of the bar, that is the gauge length of the bar is 80 mm divided by the original length of the specimen is 80 into 100. So that will be equal to 30%. So this is how we will be able to solve this particular problem. So we have taken all the considerations and all the parameters, all the unknown variables, whatever it has been given, has been found out.